his life and activities. When he was on earth dwelling among us, he was not born into an earthly royal family, but to a righteous and upright carpenter called Joseph, a descendant of Jesse. He lived like every young child with his parents, growing up physically and increasing spiritually in wisdom. B, he also went through the process of water baptism by John the Baptist, who recognized Jesus as the Messiah. He hesitated to baptize him, but Jesus prevailed upon him to perform the rite of baptism so that the scriptures might be fulfilled. C, during the baptism, the Holy Spirit in the form of a dove appeared from heaven and landed on his head, and a voice was heard saying, "Thou art my beloved Son, indeed I am well pleased." As we read in Luke 9:21-22. D. Jesus, as a human, also underwent the pangs of hunger, just like you and me. Many days we went hungry. Many days we don't have anything to eat in the house, except bread and water. Many times we even have food in the house. The food, the whole fridge is full, but no appetite. So Jesus Christ also was hungry. Can you imagine how you will feel if you are deprived of food for only 2 days? And yet he fasted for 40 days. At the end of the 40 days, he was tempted by Satan. As we also read in Luke 4:1-4, and Jesus, being full of the Holy Spirit, returned from Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, being 40 days tempted of the devil. And in those days he did eat nothing. And when they were ended, he afterwards hungered. And the devil said unto him, "If thou be the Son of God, command the stone that he be made bread." And Jesus answered him, saying, "It is written, that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of God." For 40 days and 40 nights without food or water, and you have the spiritual power to turn stone to bread, what will you do? How many of us have compromised our destinies because of food and our stomach to resign to our present deplorable situation because we could not subject the flesh to pain? It has to be satisfied. I cannot help it. It is my weakness. It is my cross. Just as Esau sold his birthright to his junior brother Isaac for a plate of pottage. And Jesus said, "It is written that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of God." For Jesus did not isolate himself and occupy an essential celestial throne on earth, being worshipped and attended to by chiefs of high-ranking knights and cardinals. But the Bible said in Luke 13:22, "And he went through the cities and villages, teaching and journeying towards Jerusalem. Then said one unto him, Lord, are there few that is saved? And he said unto them, Strive to enter in at the strait gate. For many, I say unto you, will seek to enter in and shall not be able." This is a message. "Not everyone calling my name and performing miracles in my name who enter the kingdom of heaven, yes, but only those that do the will of my Father by following my teachings and my leadership examples." Amen. 7. Jesus socialized. He was invited by high-ranking Pharisees such as Simon And he ate with him. As we also read in Luke 11:37. And as he spake, a certain Pharisee besought him to die with him. And he went in and sat down to meat. Jesus did not restrict himself to the company of the rich and the affluent. In fact, he sought after the poor, the tax collectors, who were then regarded as sinners and extortionists, the depressed, the sick, and little children. As we also read in Luke 51 and Luke 18:15, then drew near unto him all the publicans and sinners for to hear him. And the Pharisees and scribes murmured, saying, this man receives sinners and eat with them. And Luke 18:15 says, and they brought unto him also infants, that he would touch them. But when his disciples saw it, they rebuked them. But Jesus called them unto him and said, suffer little children to come unto me, and forbid them not, for of such is the kingdom of God. It is written, or it is when you know what it means to carry your cross, that you become liberated like one of these children, with nothing to fear, because their mother is at hand to protect. Similarly, you cast your hope on Christ Jesus Christ without fear. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then what about his teachings? It will be beneficial for us to understand the real message of our Lord's teachings. And that is by studying them and meditating on the divine messages, only through which we can all be saved. One, his message covered the cause of discipleship. In Luke 9:57-62, he said, and it came to pass that as they went in the way, a certain man said unto him, Lord, I will follow thee, whithersoever thou goest. And Jesus said unto him, foxes have holes, and birds of the air have nets, but the Son of Man hath nowhere to lay his head. And he said unto another, follow me. But he said, Lord, suffer me first to go and bury my father. Jesus said unto him, let the dead bury their dead, but go thou and preach the kingdom of God. And I also said, Lord, I will follow thee, but let me first go, bid them farewell, which are at home at my house. And Jesus said unto him, no man, having put his hand to the plow and looking back, is fit for the kingdom of God. And this cause of discipleship is the sacrifice we have just talked about above, which is the cross you have to carry, self-denial. If you want to follow Christ Jesus, service without complaining for reward or appreciation of man. Two, his teachings on the importance of salvation. We also read in Luke 14:15-24, and when one of them that sat at meat with him heard these things, he said unto him, blessed be he that shall eat bread in the kingdom of God. Then said he unto him, a certain man made a great supper, and made many, and he said his servant at supper time, to say to them that we have been, come, for all things are now ready. The rich man sent people. He sent his messenger to all the rich men in the town, his colleagues, his fellow rich people. Come, come and dine with me, supper is ready. So that the servant came and showed his Lord these things. Everybody started giving excuses. I have to see my daughter today. Ah, my daughter is having celebrating birthday today. Oh, my work schedule cannot make me to come. And different ridiculous excuses. None of them came. The people that he trusted, the people that he believed, they are the God's chosen people. They didn't come. Then the master of the house was being afraid. He went very angry. He said to his servant, go out quickly into the street and lay out the city and bring in here to the poor and the maimed and the halt and the blind. And the servant said, Lord, it is done as thou hast commanded, and yet there is room. And the Lord said unto the servant, go out into the highways and hedges and compel them to come in, that my house may be filled. And his house was filled with the poor, with the blind, with the crippled, with the depressed. They all came. For I say unto you, that none of those men which were bidding, he had taste of my supper. None of those rich people, none of those privileged people that were first invited, none of them would taste of my supper. And there were great multitudes with him. And he turned and said unto them, if any man come to me, and hate not his father, and hate not his mother, and hate not his wife, and hate not his children and brethren and sisters, yea, and his own life also, he cannot be my disciple. And whosoever does not bear his cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. The joy of life in the kingdom of God. We read in Luke 22 to 34. And he said unto the disciples, therefore I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what you shall eat, neither for your body, what you shall put on. The life is more than meat, and the body is more than raiment. Verse 31, but rather seek ye the kingdom of God, and all things shall be added unto you. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Then 4, the Lord's teaching on the nature of prayer. We also read in Luke 11, 1 to 13, and it came to pass that as he was praying in a certain place, when he ceased, one of his disciples said unto him, Lord, teach us to pray, as John also taught his disciples. And he said unto them, when ye pray, I want all of you to join me in this Lord's Prayer. Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And Jesus also taught his apostles humility. As we also read in Luke 14, 1 to 14. For whosoever exalted himself shall be abased, and he that humble himself shall be exhausted.
Amen.
One of the greatest sins of morality is spiritual arrogance. Carrying your cross means displaying servant leadership. Exemplified by Lord's washing the feet of the disciples. It is not when you impose your privileged earthly position and authority on those under your leadership that you win or command their respect and loyalty. You only end up awakening their indignation, rebellion, and avoidable hostility, which ultimately leads to a divided kingdom. As the Lord said in Mark 3, 24 to 26, if a kingdom is divided against itself, that kingdom cannot stand. If a house is divided against itself, that house will not be able to stand. If Satan has risen up against himself and is divided, he cannot stand, but he is finished. The Lord knew what type of cross awaits us along our path in disciple, and what is why, and that is why he advised us, if we are to retain the flock that he has given us to shepherd, as we read in Matthew 10:16, "Behold, I send you forth as sheep in the midst of wolves. Be ye therefore wise as serpents and harmless as doves." He must remain constantly in prayer, like he did for the protection of the ones that his father gave him. As we read in John 17:6-19, "I have manifested my name unto the man which thou gavest me out of the world. They are there, and thou gavest them me, and they have kept thy word. Now they have known that all things whatsoever thou hast given me are of thee. For I have given